Hello gamers and welcome to your channel. Today I will show you a game called RaiderZ Legend, a game that relaunched and was hoping to do better than last time. Let's see if it delivered, but before we jump into that, drop a like if you want to support the channel. And if you guys know something different about the game overall, feel free to leave a comment, and also you can give me a feedback on what to change or improve. So let's check the classes. In RaiderZ Legend, we have the generic classes like Defender, Berserker, Sorcerer, Cleric, and Assassin. This time, I picked the Berserker to switch things a little bit, but I ended up changing later into the game again to a Defender because it felt a little bit faster. Also, I am a Sword and Shield addict, and like all addicts, I don't need rehab. The character customization is nothing impressive, just some hairstyles, some tattoos or scars, colors on them, and that's all. After I created my Dark Knight with a huge blade, I jumped into the world. One cool thing that this game has on the plate is that you can switch classes during the game by taking weapons scattered around the map and choose another class. This thing will give you 4 skills to try on, and later you will get some magical book that will reset your points if you consider you want to pick something else that you liked. I observed that you can try different specializations only on lower levels. Let's talk about the story of the game. The game starts with no particular story, and I begin in an open field where I talk to some guy and receive my first quest. Obviously, it is to kill something. After I did that, I was sent to a big ship that was actually an inn, where I take more quests and is something like the first city in this game. Here, I met some interesting people. Then, they were teaching me how to craft my first weapon and armor set. After that, I was sent to the beach, not to relax, but to beat some monster crabs and fish gremlins. The next mission sent me to an archaeological site where I beat a big statue monster and activated some runes. This game has a lot of boss encounters scattered around the maps, and that is always a cool thing to have. I did a couple of more missions and then I was sent to retrieve an ancient document, but it turned out to be a scam and I opened the seal to a beast that now threatens the ship in city. I rushed back to it and fought some bad pirates that were jealous of our boat, and then the big creature that I released without my knowledge, the crawler. I killed it together with Tyan, the owner of the shipment, but apparently she has amnesia, because when I delivered the quest, she asked me if I handled it.
Oh, did you really handle this?
After I became the hero there, I was sent to the main city of the game and to my next adventures. Let's see the gameplay mechanics. The combat of the game is action-oriented but feels a little bit sluggish. When I hit some of my auto attacks, they didn't feel impactful, and when I have to block, it has to be like 1 second before the attack or it won't be considered a block. That was frustrating sometimes. At least, you can dodge in this game or get behind or on the side of the enemy and cripple it from there. RaiderZ Legend has a really weird stamina bar that is used for skills, but a lot of times if it reaches zero, you will press the auto attack and after 1 second it refills almost 100%. Only on higher levels I had problems. It didn't recharge, but was only when I was keeping my block up the entire time. I saw no point in this mechanic. It was really poor implemented and I don't think it is okay in an MMORPG. But if you still want to use it, please do it properly. On the good side, the game has the thing that you can break parts from enemies, and when you defeat some of them, they will leave their weapon on the ground and you can pick that and use it for a short duration. That changes things a little bit from time to time, and it was a great feature. The game even gives you different kind of bombs from what I experimented, some electrical, some explosives that do a lot of damage. You have a lot of mini bosses or bosses around the map, all with different mechanics, and some of them were really tough, even I was in the lower level zones. Let's see how the missions went. The questing in this game was not that bad and was not always kill X amount of things or gather X amount of items. They really tried to make you do different things beside that, and it was a good experience. They even spice it up with bombs, items picked from the defeated enemies, or even some of them that you will find on the quest location, like that one time I picked a cannon. Another mission that I got was on something like a temple, where I had to fight some statues and activated some magic runes. What was cool about this was that I could transform into some alien warrior creature and devastate all of them pretty easy. But because I am a dumb gamer, I caught up to that almost at the end of the mission. And until then, I was struggling with those monsters and thought that the game is beginning to be really difficult. Well, it gets, as you progress in levels, like this boss that you can damage him only if you hit his front crystal. Here, the game decided to give me a level 35 NPC to help me in battle because it knew I was a weakling and no goddamn hero. Let's check the graphics and environment. The game doesn't look that bad, a little bit outdated, but nothing to turn you off so much that you can't play. The environment is ever changing, from open fields to jungles, cemeteries, snowy mountains, deserts and much more. I liked passing through all the maps I played for this impression and got me excited to see what's next. The monsters are nothing really impressive and game changing, but neither something dull. It has the generic ones like spiders, wolves, goblins and some of them that I don't see every day, like a ghost horse with no horseman, fishman trolls, and the mini bosses in particular are pretty great and tough. Atmosphere and population. The overall atmosphere of the game was a nice one, not a really high fantasy one, but still enjoyable, with some other players popping from time to time. With some, I even talked, and one endgame player even helped me with a quest that I couldn't do solo. In the main city, I could see some cool looking players with their even cooler mounts, so it seems that some people play this game even today. Let's see how the gear is presented. This game has lots of armors and weapons that you can change almost every level and a lot of them are looking badass. What I liked was that all of the items were craftable and you have to gather the materials from monsters. You can obtain them rather quickly because all mobs drop something like 4 pieces of a few things that you will need, and you can read where you will find every item when you hover it in the crafting menu. The game offers you plenty of enchanting stones too, so I had all my gear to plus 5 every time I change it. I don't know if so many items were dropping before the relaunch too, or is it just now so you can obtain things easily. I liked that the game didn't offer me some shitty gift that will give me crazy strong gear, and I was looking forward to craft my new set or weapon. Endgame. RaiderZ Legend endgame consists in some epic dungeon and loot farming like in most MMORPGs. To enter in an epic dungeon, you need a key or rune that can be obtained by doing daily quests and something called an admission quest. Other things you can do is hunting epic monsters, do more daily quests and PvP. The game, from what I read from the forums, is not pay to win and that is always a good thing for a game. Okay gamers, all of that being said, let's check the pros and cons. But before that, support me in the fight with the algorithm beast by dropping a like shield around the video and also, if you want to become part of the legacy, consider subscribing. If you want to support me into making content even further, check my Patreon. And don't forget, I try games, so you don't have to waste your time. And let's finish with the fun factor. I liked that the game had cool gear sets that you can craft by yourself. The questing was not so boring that some of them were unique and although a lower player base, they were helpful. What I disliked about the game is that the action combat needs more polished when attacking and blocking. Some of the bosses were a little bit hard because they were keeping me on the ground all the time and the dodge mechanic didn't work properly too. Overall, I enjoyed the game and was pretty excited when I would craft my new equipment or reach a new zone. Also, that there was an existing player base that I interacted with. I think the game is worth playing it for a decent adventure, like how I treat some MMORPGs. I play until I reach endgame and consider them something like a campaign game. I like the journey and when it feels too grindy and I don't think the game is worth investing, I quit. So that was all about RaiderZ Legend. Thank you for watching and if you want to check more impressions for games, feel free to check my channel. Have a grindy day!